Trevor the traction engine was lonely. Edward came to see him every day, but there wasn't enough work for Trevor to do. It depressed him terribly. "I like to keep busy," he sighed one day, "and I do like company, especially children." "Cheer up," said Edward. "Sir Topham Hatt has a job for you. He sent me to tell you all about it. I'm to take you to the junction to meet Thomas today." "Oh," exclaimed Trevor happily, "a harbor. That means a seaside, and that means children. How marvelous." Thomas was waiting at the junction. He was on his way to the harbor with a trainload of steel pilings. These were to be built into the harbor wall to make them firm and safe. "Hello, Thomas," said Edward. "This is Trevor, an old friend of mine. He's a traction engine." Thomas eyed the newcomer doubtfully. "A what?" he asked. "A traction engine," exclaimed Trevor. "A steam engine who runs on roads instead of rails. Can you take me to the harbor, please? Edward says Sir Topham Hatt has a job for me." Workmen coupled Trevor's flat car to Thomas's train and they set off. "Useful engines run on rails," Thomas grumbled to himself, but luckily Trevor didn't hear him. "I'm glad Sir Topham Hatt needs me," said Trevor happily. "I don't have enough to do sometimes, you know, although I can work anywhere. In orchards, on farms, in scrapyards, even in harbors." Thomas was puzzled. "But you don't run on rails," he objected. "I don't need rails to be useful," replied Trevor. "You wait and see." But when they reached the harbor, they found everything in confusion. Cars had come off the rails, blocking the line, and the stone they had held lay everywhere. "We must get these pilings past," said Thomas's driver. "They're essential. If only we had a tractor to drag them round this mess. Terence could have done it." "Just the sort of job I like," interrupted Trevor excitedly. "Get me off this car, please. Now I'll show you what a traction engine can do." Quickly, they unloaded him and he set to work at once. First, he dragged the stones clear with chains. Then he towed into position the pilings which Thomas had brought so that they were ready for the workmen to use. Everything was shipshape before the foreman could say Sir Topham Hatt. And later, when Thomas brought Annie and Clarabelle full of children from the villages along his branch line, Trevor gave them rides along the harbor. Time of his life. "He's very kind," said Annie. "He reminds me of Thomas," added Clarabelle. Everyone was sorry when it was time for Trevor to go. They loaded him onto his car once more, and Thomas pulled him to the junction. "I'll come and see you again if I can," he promised. "And if those silly cars don't behave, we may need you again." "That would be wonderful," said Trevor. And that night, he fell happily asleep under the apple trees at the Vicarage Orchard. He dreamt of Thomas, Sir Topham Hatt's harbor, and most of all, children.